In other online training videos, we have learned about our dimension tools and defaults. In this video, let's take a look at dimensioning in elevation and cross-section views. First, I'll open this elevation view that I've created in front of this house by selecting the elevation camera icon and then clicking on the Open View tool in the Edit toolbar here at the bottom. Or you can double-click on the camera to open the view. There are three ways to dimension in elevation views: manual dimensions, automatic dimensions, and story pole dimensions. Manual dimensions are created the same way you create them in floor plan view. You can find the dimension tools under the CAD drop-down menu under Dimensions. Here you can see all of the manual dimension tools available. I typically use three of these in my elevation views: the manual dimension tool, the end-to-end dimension tool, and the point-to-point dimension tool. The manual dimension tool is used the same way you would use it in floor plan view. You can also find the dimension tool parent tool here in your toolbar for quick access. Just click on the parent tool, and then on the first tool in the child bar, here at the left side of your screen, this is the manual dimension tool. Then click and drag a line across the objects that you want to dimension. The look and behavior of the dimensions will follow the active dimension defaults. If I go up here to the default settings tool, the little white wrench, and then down to dimensions, you will see all of the saved dimension defaults. Here at the bottom, you can see which of these is active. It will be initially set the same as the plan view you were in when you created the camera view, but you can change it here by clicking on this drop-down and selecting the save dimension set you prefer. If I select one and click on Edit, you can find all of the settings that determine how your dimensions will behave and what they will look like, including the dimension line setup, the number format, what objects will be located and where they are located, how the extension lines behave, what layer the dimensions will be placed on, the style of arrow, and the style of text to be used. You can learn more about all of these settings in additional online training videos. Once you have created a dimension line, just like in floor plan view, it can be edited. You can move the line using the Move Edit handle. You can remove the extension lines by clicking on the dimension line to get the diamond-shaped edit handles at the end of the extension lines. Then click on the one that you want to remove and drag it away from the object it's attached to. You can add extension lines by using the dangling diamond edit handle that always shows up next to the Move Edit handle. Click and drag this diamond to another object that you want your dimension to locate. If I want a dimension from the first floor to the second story window header, I could use the manual dimension tool, but notice that it will find all of the heights between the two spots. So instead, I will use my end-to-end dimension tool. That will locate the first object, create an extension line to it, then snap to the next, creating another extension line, until I move farther. Then it will find the next object and remove the extension to that first object. As I continue, it will create one dimension relative only to the initial object located. It will find the top of the window when I release the pick button on my mouse. It will create a dimension line from one end to another without locating all of the objects in between. If you have difficulty with the dimension lines locating the object you want to dimension, you can use the point-to-point dimension tool. This tool will create its own dimension points if it cannot locate an object. Once you have drawn a dimension line with dimension points, you can move the point and change the dimension. You can also use the dimension to move the point to a precise position by selecting the point marker and then click on the dimension number to open the editor. Now you can type in the precise number you want. So if I want a dimension line that goes to the bottom of this beam, notice that the dimension line will not locate the bottom of the beam, only the top. So I will use the point-to-point dimension tool. Then I will need to zoom in close to make sure my dimension point is on the line that I want dimensioned. You also have the option to use automatic dimensions. If we go here to the Automatic Dimensions tool, Parent tool, you will find the Auto Elevation Dimensions tool. The look and behavior of these dimensions will follow the Auto Elevation tool defaults. You will find these again if we go to the Default Settings Parent tool and then double-click on Auto Elevation Dimensions. The defaults found here will control some of the characteristics of the dimensions that generate. The dimensions position in Elevation View, top, bottom, left, and right, the objects to be located by the extension lines, the heights or elevations such as the finished floor, at each floor level, or the ridge of the roof. The layer that the dimension lines will be placed on are also controlled by the Auto Elevation Dimension defaults. All of the defaults not controlled here will be determined by the Active Dimension defaults, including the arrow style and the text style. Once you have created automatic dimensions, you can edit them by moving the dimension lines or adding or removing extension lines. You can also make changes to each dimension line by selecting it, then clicking on the Open Object tool to open the Dimension Specification dialog. Here you can change the overall dimension defaults that it's following, or customize individual characteristics like the format, extensions, layer, and arrow. If you have changed the Auto Elevation Dimension defaults after generating dimensions, you can update them easily by clicking again on the Auto Elevation Dimensions tool. However, once you've customized a dimension line, remember that it will no longer automatically update when you click on the Auto Elevation Dimension tool, as the others do. An easy way to delete all the dimensions at once is to use the Active Tool Selection mode. Click on the Dimension Tool Parent tool. That will activate the Manual Dimension tool. Then hold down your Shift key and draw a selection box around everything. Because the Dimension tool is active, it will only select the dimensions. Then click on the Delete button in the Edit toolbar here at the bottom of your screen, or you can hit your Delete key on your keyboard. This will not work by clicking on the Auto Elevation Dimensions tool. That will simply regenerate the auto elevation dimensions. Another tool you can use for dimensioning cross sections and elevations is the story pole dimensions. You can find the story pole dimensions tool again under the automatic dimensions parent tool. When I click on auto story pole dimensions, it will automatically dimension the building component heights. You will notice that the dimensions here can create dimension lines just like the auto elevation dimensions, but will add height markers and labels. These dimensions, like the auto elevation dimensions, have their own default settings. If we go to the Default Settings button in the toolbar, go down to Dimensions, then to Auto Story Pole Dimensions, you can change the way your story pole dimensions behave and look. Once you have the defaults edited, click again on the Auto Story Pole Dimensions tool. It will delete the previously generated dimensions and create new ones accordingly. You can learn more about the Auto Story Pole Dimension tool and their defaults in another online training video. All of these dimension tools work the same way in an elevation view and in a back-clipped cross-section view. Let's go back here to the floor plan and take note of the dimension defaults that are currently active here in my floor plan view, the 1/4 inch scale dimension defaults. Now, if we create a back-clipped cross-section, you'll notice, as I had mentioned before, that the same dimension defaults are currently active in this camera view. If a different set of dimension defaults has been active in the floor plan, they would be active here. And remember that you can change them, either by going in to the default settings, as we had before, or by using the Active Dimension Defaults control button conveniently placed here in your toolbar. Just like in Elevation View, here you can use Manual Dimension Tools, or your automatic dimension tools, and when I use the story pole dimension tool, they will follow the same defaults as we had set in the elevation view. The default set for each tool will remain the same regardless of the view that you are using it in, until you go into your default settings and change them.